Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse, horse, horse. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, in today's video, we're gonna get the swing arm and the forks off, but we run into a problem already. Seems like every old bolt and nut seems to be stripped, and on old bikes, it's hard not to get a stripped bolt or a nut, and we're trying to take the front wheel off so we'll have enough room to slide the forks out. Got three of the four nuts out or bolts out, and then one strip, so we're trying to get that out before we can slide the wheel off to slide the forks down.
We always tend to run into some problems. As you can see, we got three out of the four bolts loose, and as you can tell, it just totally stripped. If it'll focus in, just totally stripped that one out. We tried everything, vice grips, pliers, and it just don't seem to be coming out. I put these tires on, I tightened those nuts and bolts up, everything on this, like the tires wise. I put these back on when I put new tires on it, and I don't remember at all tightening these up that tight where it just stripped out. I may have, but honestly, I don't remember. New wheel bearings that I have to put in. As you can see, these are completely shot. Got the seal and everything just coming out, completely shot. So we're gonna have to get that off eventually. Got the forks off, made sure to put all the nuts and bolts back where they go so you don't forget and lose them. Got them laying in there. Didn't get the wheel off. I can do that later on once I get down to that part. I'm doing the motor and the frame and stuff right now, so I ain't really worrying about changing the wheel bearings. That's the only reason I got to take the front wheel off, so wheel bearings are completely gone. But for now, we'll let that sit aside and get this swing arm off. What fun it is to ride. Come on, swing arm, just pop loose. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. What fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. What fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Open sleigh, o'er the fields we go.
And just like that, not really just like that, took longer than expected. Everything I try to do always seems to take longer than expected. Got the shock off. Probably going to rebuild that or clean it up and just adjust it for my weight. And got the bars off. Going to clean those up. They should clean up very, very good where I don't have to go out and buy new bars. They look like they're just a little bit dirty. And those should be pretty good. Got the frame here to go. Ready to go. Got the frame off. Looking good. Just got to get it cleaned up. Told you guys in the last few videos that I'd probably get the frame and wheels powder coated. But I think I've changed my mind on that. I painted my YZ125 frame, which was the exact color. All the older Yamahas have the Ford color blue. If you guys are looking to paint your frame and you want to use some good quality spray paint that won't chip or crack or anything when you're riding it, I use Duplicates Ford color blue paint. You can get it at like a parts store, AutoZone, Advanced. I tried Walmart and stuff like that. They don't carry it. They only have it at like car places, car stores, car part stores, and you can get it there for probably $7-$8 a can, I think it was, and it probably takes 2 or 3 cans if you want it to look nice. If you guys are, you know, looking to paint your frames, your older Yamaha frames, and want to keep it the same color, all you got to do, run to your local part store, and it took me a few places to get the paint. Some places didn't, you know, have it in, some would have to order it. Took me a few places, a few stores to go through to get the paint. But after it was, you know, after I got it, it was well worth it. It's the same exact color, blue, duplicates Ford color blue, the exact color for the Yamaha frames, which is pretty sick. You want to make sure if you're painting your Yamaha frame back to the same stock color, you want to make sure you get the Ford color blue, because you don't want it looking like that. You don't want it looking like, you know, you can see the different color blues in there. You don't want it looking like that. So you want to make sure to get the exact color paint or you'll screw your motor up. Like I said, your frame. But like I said, guys, I thought I'd powder coat it. But after looking over the frame and stuff, just seeing some places, like look at that. Just rubbing my thumb over it, taking all the dirt off, and it's shiny. Not really scratched up at all, and still looks good. So after I get all this grease and dirt and stuff off of it, then a couple cans of that spray paint should make this frame, you know, look new again. As you can see, the bottom of the frame is where most of the rocks and dirt and everything hits the frame. As you can see, you can just wipe that off with your finger, and that looks, you know, that's still shiny, still looks good. So a few colors or a few cans of that spray paint should do the trick and do the job. Got this bowl of parts, carburetor, nuts, bolts, brake pedals and stuff like that. I can probably get those cleaned up really nice and get that carb cleaned up, shined up. Got the motor inside the engine, as you can see in the beginning of the video, that is in my room. Been working on the engine for a few days now, and it is starting to look amazing. Took you guys' suggestions and used some Scotch-Brite pads, and it really does a miracle on some aluminum. I finally found it. I thought I was gonna have to go back to the stock bore and pick up a new cylinder head and the rebuild kit, which would have cost me over $700. Wasn't looking forward to that, but after some research, I finally found a good website and that has the rebuild kits. It's actually inside right now. Got everything, you know, I got a few parts in that you guys are gonna be excited to see on the engine and the bike and everything once it gets done. But I'm probably gonna do an unboxing. I'm just waiting. I haven't posted in a week. Been waiting on all the parts to get here. Been cleaning up the engine, getting it ready. You can't really do, you know, a full good job trying to record, set up the camera. So I thought, why not take it in my room for a little bit? Saw some comments. I've had my engine in my room for weeks. I was like, that sounds like a good idea. Brought it in my room, and I've been cleaning it up with some Scotch-Brite pads, degreaser, and some toothbrushes and stuff like that, and it really does a miracle to your engines. And I'll probably do an unboxing on all the parts when they get here. But yeah, guys, if you enjoyed this video, thought I'd come out here. It's a pretty day, 70 something degrees out here. The wind's blowing nice, feels good, not raining, and the skies are blue. Thought I'd come out here and make a video for you guys. It's been raining all dang week. You can probably tell on the ground and stuff, soaking wet. But it's been wet, muddy, rainy. Just not a good time. And today has been pretty good. Come out here, wind's blowing, feels super nice. And good day to come out here, make a video for you guys and work on the bike. But yeah, guys, if you enjoyed, make sure you share with a friend. Tell them I'm doing a build. I'm gonna be painting up this this frame. Next video after that. My next video might be me continue to work on the engine, getting it cleaned up, because I got some parts coming in for the engine, just the engine. And it's gonna make everything look super sick, so I can't wait for all of that. But yeah, guys, off of that, like I said, if you enjoyed, can't wait for the bike to be done, smash the like button, share with a friend. So close to hitting 45,000 subscribers. And yeah, so close, can't wait. And I will catch you guys on the next video. Have a good day, guys. Peace out.
Don't worry, baby, I'll be back.